What's going on, everyone? Chrisman here, and today I want to talk about Dark and Darker. And there's been a lot of controversy about this game as of late, the past few weeks. And there's been some recent updates. That's the reason I'm talking about this. If you want to see a full breakdown in the description of this video, I'm going to put a link to a video from Devin Nash. He's a big Dark and Darker fan, but more importantly than that, he is someone who is way smarter than me and has done a lot more research into this. And so his video is 46 minutes long, so, you know, probably grab some food and, you know, sit down and watch a good video or crank it on 2x speed like an absolute Chad would. But I want to talk about this because there's been a recent development since he posted that video. That video is from 4 days ago. This article is from 1 day ago, where the Dark and Darker dev has tried doing some interesting updates. So they started a GoFundMe here, and I guess it was paused because they weren't exactly ready for it, or it wasn't supposed to be put out, essentially. They did receive, it looks like, $32,000 as of this. I heard that they received, like, $45,000 at some point. So, that's a lot of money. The interesting thing, and thing that I'm kind of really confused about, is I'm not super big on, like, courts and legal fees, and stuff, but I'm pretty sure $500,000 is, like, not a lot of money. So, I'm not quite sure, because I believe Nexon's worth, like, billions. The B. So this is probably like a month, maybe. Like, if I don't know how much longer this is. Maybe I can get someone in the comment section who's a fucking lawyer and be like, yeah, this is actually gonna last them 26.34 days. Like, all right, cool, that'd be sweet. This seems like really weird, though. This seems really weird. I get that these are the little guys and everyone's rooting for them because the big company's the evil one, but when I look into this and when I hear stuff about this game, it just looks like it looks stolen, man. I'm sorry. This game looks stolen. I'm going to close out of this tab here. I want you guys to look at this. This is Project P3, which is the game that Nexon was publishing and some of the devs from Dark and Darker were working on. I'm going to full screen this video here for you guys so you can see it. I just want you guys to look at this video and see if this possibly looks like any other game that you maybe have seen before. We're just going to let this loop for a little bit so you can kind of take everything in here. We've got survivors in the top right. We've got classes here that you can select. Barbarian, wizard, fighter, ranger. Yeah, okay. We've got a UI down here with a chest that you have to open slowly. It's like a use process here. You've got your weapons. You've got certain assets here as well, like utilities, healing, light source, etc. There's a mini-map up here as well. Altar of Resurrection, Portal, Shrine. You've got your compass up here. Okay, now I've taken this all in, right? Now I'm going to show you guys another video, okay? This is a video from Jack Frags. I'm not stealing his whole video, I promise, Jack. I'm just gonna joint the UI section here. Does this look at all similar? Okay, there are some definite changes for sure, right? We've got this mini-map's down here now. It's not up here, it's down here. UI is a bit different. Teammate health was under the minimap here. Now it's over here. Okay. Still got your torch there. You've got UI elements were shifted over here. You still got the middle thing. Okay, interesting. I don't know if one reasonable person looks at these two different things, and go back if you need to, and says, oh yeah, that looks like a totally different game. If that's you, I can't tell you. I can't tell you what to do, man. These games look very similar aesthetically, okay? They're also very similar in terms of gameplay, okay? I'm going to show this here. I'm going to go to everyone's favorite website, Reddit. I fucking hate this website, okay? This website's good for about two things, porn and circle jerking, okay? Sometimes, I mean, it probably really excels when you combine those two, but that's not me. So this is a screenshot from P3. And as you can see, looks like that game from two things ago. So we're gonna look at some of the comments here that people talk about in this, because some of you guys are huffing an unhealthy amount of copium. Okay, you guys need to come back down to earth. Okay, let's come back down to earth and let's realize this game is probably never coming out, and it looks pretty bad that it's maybe stolen. Okay, having a side-by-side comparison of these assets would be a lot more beneficial than just screenshot circling things. Yeah, man, if only I could. This was like a month ago too, by the way. So this was like, I think they were having an open beta at this time, or I don't know the exact date that this was posted. If only we could maybe, I don't know, look up the UI ourselves and see maybe some of these things are stolen. God. Battlefront 2 has the exact same kill feed. I'm sure many games have it. I think a lot of people are losing the plot. of why Iron Mace Games is being sued. It's not because the fucking kill feed's in the top right. Okay? It's not because the minimap's over here or this asset is stolen. That might be a part of it. Okay? These assets might be a part of it. It's rumored that there was like a... Nexon filed their official lawsuit, and Devin Nash covers this in his video again. Please go watch that video. He does a much better job of explaining it than I will. In his video, he talks about... Nexon lists out about 1,000 assets that are stolen. Guys, I want to make this very clear. I'm not a video game developer. I don't work in video games. Video games have hundreds of thousands of files. Hundreds of thousands of files. It would be very easy to squeeze 1,000 files in somewhere and be like, see, look, we didn't steal these. Look at all these files. They're just scrolling through like the fucking pages, and there's like just seeing thousands and thousands of files. There could be 1,000 in there and stolen. You have no idea. Even if there was a police raid, we don't know what they found. Nexon didn't say anything. The police didn't say anything. Iron Mace is saying they found nothing. Okay, all right. Hey, that's if that's true, then they found nothing. Who knows? Without anything to compare this to, it's useless. Like, these Redditors are so lazy. They're trying so hard to be like, I love this game. There can't be anything wrong with it. There can't be. But the cope is going to be next, okay? Pointing out that there are PV, PVE, and BR elements that revive altars and portals makes no sense when these are all common elements in games. I agree. For that, we're going to reference, not this screenshot again, we're going to reference the best-selling video games of all time. I apologize for guys. I should have given you a warning. That's my bad. Yeah, I love when I play Minecraft, dude, and I get I see that exact revive altar. Yeah, I loved that. Or when I was playing Grand Theft Auto 5, and I saw that mosquito acid in there. Yeah, that's a really... Like, what are you on? This guy brings up an interesting concept here. How many MOBAs have been released that steal assets? I think this is a really big deal because I feel like I've seen games steal Dota's assets in the past, and Valve has sued the fuck out of them. Okay, I'm sure this happens with League. I'm sure this happens with every other game, probably outside of China, because I know China, they have weird copyright laws and stuff, or they don't have copyright laws. I'm not sure how that works. I feel like everyone who makes a game and just blatantly copies icons and assets and names and all that shit gets sued the fuck out of business, and you never hear from them again. So for him to bring this up is like, okay, that's interesting. These all seem like pretty generic things to have in games. I agree. Every fantasy PvPvE game I've ever played, first-person fantasy PvPvE game I've ever played, has these exact same things in it. Every single one. They all have this extraction, loot system, altars and shrines where you team up with your friends and you go through these tight corridors and dungeons and, you battle out the enemies and stuff. I can't believe. It's just, it blows my mind. People are such big fans of this game, and they want something to be true so bad, they will just blindly, they will, like, close their eyes. They'll be like, nope, I don't see it. It's like a totally different game to me. Bro, go outside, okay? Go get some fresh air. Go pick up a job. Go back to school. Go do something. You need to get away from this, okay? Because while, yes, this does seem like a really good game, I've played 15 minutes of it. I didn't much care for it, but I played 15 fucking minutes of it and closed out of it, and I was in a bad mood that day, so that's not even a good, like... Not even a good... If anything, I'd be like, I fucking hate this game, but I played 15 minutes of it. I don't know anything about this game, okay? And I don't know who the fuck Nexon is, okay? From Nexon's perspective, I can see why people would be mad, right? It looks like Nexon... Or from Iron Mace's perspective, sorry. From Iron Mace's perspective, it looks like they were working on this game, and then they left, and then they re-released it, and people are like, oh, wait a minute, this looks really cool. And Nexon was like, yo, the fuck? Some bullshit. That's our game. I can see where the jealousy would be there. From Nexon's perspective, though, this looks very similar. And there's more than just people are trying to say, oh, they stole assets. First off, they might have stolen assets. That's one of the alleged things they claim in the lawsuit. The other more important thing is trade secrets, right? This was a canceled project that P3, that Nexon had, okay? Imagine if you had studied hard for like a test and then some fucking guy sitting next to you stole all your answers. And every answer you ever wrote down, and... You stole, like, let's say you, like, wrote the little drawings on your fucking test, right? You showed, like, let's say it was a math test. Not only did he steal your answer, he stole all your work, too. Show the problem being solved. He stole all that, and he stole your exact drawings. Maybe you put a stick figure on the next to your name every time you do one, right? And he stole that, too. You should be pissed. That's your test, brother. He just took that from you. The fact that people are trying to justify this is like, oh, well, Iron Mace is a small studio, and this is what's going to happen next. Iron Mace is a small studio, so it's okay for them to steal assets. I'm going to come out with a couple base takes here, guys, okay? It's never okay to steal. All right. I don't care if you're a small company. I don't care if you're a big company. I don't care if you're a medium-sized company. I don't care if you're a random guy. I don't care if you're Bill Gates. I don't care if you're fucking Jesus Christ. Okay? It's not okay to steal. All right? Go steal shit. If you guys sitting down, I'm gonna come up with another big one. Don't hurt people. Okay? Don't attack people. Don't kill people. Don't do crazy shit. Okay? This is just like, it's not okay. It's not okay for them. If they did steal this shit and it looks very similar to the game that they had stolen, I understand they can't copyright a franchise or an IP or a genre, okay? I understand you can't, well, you can't copyright an IP and a franchise. You can't copyright a game genre. But if Iron Mace had come out and released this game, and let's say it was a third-person open-world extraction fantasy game, do you think Nexon would still be suing them? I don't think they would. Because it's like, fuck, that doesn't look anything like the game we had them working on. Problem isn't that the problem isn't the potentially stolen assets, although that can be a problem. The problem isn't that it's a PvPvE game. The problem is they're both dungeon crawling looter extraction PvPvE games that look very similar in terms of gameplay style. They look very similar in terms of how graphical fidelity. They look very similar, okay? And Nexon kind of has a right to be pissed, in my opinion. It looks pretty bad. I hope Iron Mace win, because it seems like a lot of people are really excited about this game, and it will bring a lot of happiness and joy to people. But at the end of the day, something good's going to come out of this, because guess what? Somebody else is going to state this concept there and be like, yoink, I'm going to take this whole concept, I'm going to re-release it, and my game's going to blow up, hopefully. We'll see what ends up happening. Anyway, third time in this video, I'm going to make sure to reference, go watch that Devin Ash video. I know it's 46 minutes, guys, but if you can sit here and watch me talk about this fucking game for 12 minutes, a game that I played 15 minutes, then by all means, you can watch his video. He goes into much greater detail. He goes into the lawsuit, sees what the Nexon is alleging and stuff. And he's a big Dark and Darker fan. So, anyway, well, thank you guys for watching. I will see you in the next one. Peace.